At a college for the deaf and hard of hearing, the word is out. Signs on campus support effective consent. Yes means yes, no means no. Gallaudet University recently made news when it was determined that it had the highest rate of reported sexual assaults in the country.
Any marginalized community faces its own set of challenges and own set of dynamics when it comes to sexual assault.
The numbers, campus officials say, are hard to interpret. Lower numbers don't necessarily mean fewer assaults are happening. It might just mean that victims aren't coming forward. In 2012, 18 cases were reported at Gallaudet, the highest number in 3 years for the school of 1,500. A grant that same year from the Department of Justice Office of Violence Against Women has set off campus-wide momentum to address sexual misconduct. So what does change look like?
Well, I think it's important to recognize that we're looking at sexual assault, we're also looking at dating and domestic violence, we're looking at stalking.
They are using the money and requirements of the grant to set up extensive training and new teams and new ways of communicating. The grant has helped create mandatory online education for students, faculty and student trainings throughout the year, 3 sexual assault response teams known as SART.
When we were writing the grant, they require for you to have a SART. Well, we decided that this was a really fabulous idea and that would allow us to coordinate our services, allow us to have a space where we could regularly discuss the issues that come up, regularly look at what are some new strategies in prevention education.
So far, 40 faculty and staff have had bystander training, meaning they learn how to intervene to try to prevent an assault. 100 students have been trained, and the goal is to have 500 trained by the end of the 2016 academic year. The sensitivity and accessibility to students who use sign language is why many of them opt to report assaults on campus rather than to local authorities.
When a student comes to any office on campus, they can talk directly to that person. If they go off campus, say, for example, a resource, a social service agency, or a certain offices in the MPD, they may have to use an interpreter, which means they have to talk through somebody else. And when you're looking at sexual assaults, domestic violence, dating violence, stalking, with the level of sensitivity, having any additional people makes it less comfortable.
Faculty and staff are listening to what students want, more alcohol-free events, such as this Friday night party. Alternative parties begin the first week of classes and activities are scheduled throughout the year.
When it comes to drugs and alcohol, that can...
The university is also sponsoring health and wellness fairs, such as this one called Are You Sure?, which bring community resources together so students can learn how to keep themselves safe. One program gaining traction with students is a national bystander intervention program called Green Dot.
This bystander intervention component is huge. You know, in terms of sexual assault prevention, for so many years we looked at, okay, how do we educate people not to rape? How do we educate people on how to protect themselves? And for the first time, we're really taking a look at, okay, there's so many other people in between, you know, and for the first time, we've recognized that, you know, the majority of cases have lots and lots of people who could have stopped it or could have reduced it. And this really reduces the burden on that victim.
This is personal for Gannon, who is the daughter of 2 Gallaudet graduates.
People know me personally and they know me, you know, they have pictures of me when I was a baby, you know, and now I'm working with them in a professional capacity. That's a really huge component about Gallaudet and about the deaf community, and that has its strengths and it has its challenges.
As a faculty member for 30 years, Associate Dean Carl Pramick says he's seen changes not only in policy, but culture as well.
The policy in the past, because of various laws that were passed in the early 60s and 70s, focused a lot on how to protect the rights of the person who was charged and who's responding to the violations. So we've seen a shift where we see a lot of focus being put on the victim and the victim advocacy and giving that support to the victim and their rights. So it's much more balanced than the policies that were in place back then.
Pramick says new technologies are prompting the university to think about new ways to get the message out that sexual assault has no place on campus.
Obviously, during my time, communication was always being in person. All the social gatherings were always in a visual environment where people were together, where people, everyone signs. Use sign language, and we use the phone so much. Right now we have a variety of options on how students get together and socialize. They also have Twitter and Facebook and social media in the picture now compared to back then. So how we deliver our programs have to change. And they had to change to fit the population as well as the trends.
And today we're asking you, are you sure? This is a question you should be asking yourselves every day.
In just a few years, senior Claire Tucker has also witnessed cultural change at Gallaudet.
Well, I know for me, when I first came to Gallaudet, I had a lot of new experiences being in a new environment, meeting lots of new people my first year. And I developed a lot of friendships. Some folks had been through some experiences, and I've seen a lot over my time here. And one thing I can say is the attitude and culture at Gallaudet has dramatically changed. I see a lot more kind of positive change happening on campus, and it's really exciting to see that and also to look forward to what the future holds.
As a sophomore, Rebecca Shinkowski didn't realize how soon she would use her training.
I had my Green Dot training, and then that night, I was really reflecting on how much I had learned during the training. And over in Clare Hall, one of the dormitories, there was a party. There's always lots of parties that are going on. People end up there under the influence. And I had a good friend of mine who, in fact, was under the influence. I was trying to take her back to her room just to make sure she would be safe. But there was another person who didn't want to let go of her. And they were kind of tugging her back. And we sort of had a tug of war between this person. I finally got my friend back to her dorm room. The next morning, she thanked me because she didn't remember anything that happened the night before.
You know, we have all these numbers and we have all these stats, but at the end of the day, it's really hard to measure effectiveness. And it's really hard to show, okay, we're making a difference here. But when we have a story like that, you know, if I could have 100 stories like that, then, you know, we would know that we're really doing the right thing.